In this short video, I'm going to explain to you how to overcome a key objection. And that objection is, you've looked at your CV and you've thought, oh my God, I was 18 months here, 12 months there, 18 months here, 12 months there. How am I going to explain that to an interviewer? Well, what I'm going to do in this very short video is explain a good way of doing it. So the first thing is watch the other videos. If you've moved around a bit, God help you, you need to start getting good at doing interviews. You need to be outstanding because you're going to come up against people who've got better track records. So follow the other videos, they will help. Make sure particularly that you're preparing a portfolio of evidence. So it's a five-step process here for managing this particular objection in interviews. First things first, you've got to confront it. At some point in the interview, you've got to say to the interviewer, does it bother you that I've moved around a little bit? You can't hide it. It is going to be there in the back of the mind of the interviewer. You cannot obfuscate it. So at some point you have to front it up. The amount of times I send a candidate to an interview, or we send candidates to interviews, where their track record is a little bit choppy, the candidate comes out, says the interview went great, and then the client rings me and says, nice guy's moved around a lot. Not for me. That happens all the time. The candidates that do well with it front it, handle it, and close on it. So point one, be prepared to confront it. Well, how do you confront it? Well, at some point in the interview, you've got to bring it up. Mr. Interviewer, Mrs. Interviewer, Miss Interviewer, whatever. Does it bother you that I might have had a few more jobs than I would have liked to have had over the last few years? Some might say, no, I don't care really, you seem great. Some might say, well, actually, yeah, I am concerned about it. At that point, the candidates that do well will say, why? Well, they won't say why, because why is a pretty aggressive way of approaching it. They'll say, what is it about it that bothers you? And the client will say the following things. Now, before I get into the best answer to that, there's a few things I want to go through as part of our process. Point two, get your research done. Of all the people in the market who need to have researched a job like they're preparing for Dragon's Den, it's you. If you've moved around a little bit, my God, there should be nothing you don't know about the company that you're going to an interview for and the market in which they operate. You should be like a stock market analyst on that position by the time you walk into that room. Point three, under no circumstances must you allow the interview to become a chronological review of your CV. That is why you've got to watch these videos over and over again so that you can create an interview in which you are probing for the client's needs and your ability to demonstrate your skills in relation to those needs. If you allow the interviewer to take control at the tell me about you stage of the process, and you allow them to sit there and take a chronological, historical overview of your CV, frankly, you're screwed. You will walk out of that interview unsuccessful. Stage four, every shred of evidence that you've got that proves that irrespective of the fact that you've made short spelled moves, you must have in a portfolio. Nobody needs more proof and evidence of success than a candidate whose CV is a little bit choppy. It couldn't be more essential because it solves all problems. You've moved around a little bit. Yeah, but actually I was pretty successful in the jobs I've been in. Great, problem solved. So the objection itself, you turn around to the client and you say, okay, to what extent is it an issue for you that I've moved around a little bit more than I would have liked? As I've said, some are going to say, I don't care. Some are going to say, well, actually, yeah, it's a bit of a problem for me, mate. At that point, the next question you ask is, what is it about that that bothers you? This is the funny bit. They won't be able to answer you. They won't know. They don't know. They just think they should be bothered by the fact that your CV looks choppy. But they don't know why. It's just public zeitgeist. Psyche. It's just a stupid thing. Doesn't really mean anything. They just think they should be bothered by it, but most of them don't quite know. It's your job to lead them through the process. So at that point you say, well, there's probably two reasons why you're bothered. Reason one, you might be worried I'm not very good. No one's ever going to say that to you. So you therefore have to front the objection. Or it might be that you're worried that I haven't really thought about and I'm not thinking about the moves I make and thinking about my career with sufficient due diligence and thought. And I was wondering if I could cover both of those issues with you now. One, in terms of whether I'm very good or not, well, here's some evidence that proves that actually, irrespective of the fact that I've made some bad moves, I'm actually a good salesman. But yeah, I've made some bad moves and it hasn't worked out for me for one reason or another. But as you can see, I was successful there, I won that deal there, I did that deal there, and in many respects, I did it in spite of the moves I made, not because of. Two, you're probably right, I possibly could have been a little bit more duly diligent with the moves I've made. That's why I've done all this research that I've done on this job interview today. And that's the point at which you demonstrate how deeply duly diligent you've gone. Because you can say, do you know what? Maybe I haven't been as duly diligent. Maybe I have, to be fair, backed a couple of losers. Because let's get it right. If I'm hiring a guy and he keeps backing losers, I'm asking myself in my own subconscious, does this guy go after shit deals as well? Does he back loser deals? So you've got to demonstrate to them that you can do the research, that you can do the homework. You can say, that's why I've done the due diligence I've done on this interview today. That's why I've thought about this interview I'm sat in front of you at right now. Because I know deep down in my heart, this is a great opportunity for me. And then at that point, you close on it. Does that make you happy? Are you comfortable with the fact that I've had a lot of jobs, but you can understand at the same time that I'm actually a half decent sales guy. I'm just in a little bit of a rough patch at the moment. Yes, it does. Great. Let's move on. What else are you looking for? And you go back to the process that we outlined in the videos. But it's two things. Whatever you do, don't get into a chronological, historical review of your CV. You'll spend the whole interview justifying why you left each job. And that's going to take up a boatload of selling time in a 1 hour interview. Get straight into it, overcome it, and get into, are you worried I'm not very good? Yes. They'll never say it. They'll go, Nobody's ever going to say, yes, I'm worried you're not very good. But it gives you the opportunity to handle the objection. Good luck.